It's Medicosis Perfectionalis, and we're still talking about rheumatoid arthritis. How do we manage it? Today we'll talk about the non-TNF inhibitors, disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. By rheumatic, we mean anti-rheumatoid. Let's get started. We have talked about the clinical manifestations of rheumatoid arthritis before, and how to diagnose it. And now we're talking about how to treat it, medical or surgical. You go to the internal medicine doctor for this one, you go to the surgeon for this one, and then the medical, non-steroidals or DMARDs or other immunosuppressants such as steroids, etc. DMARDs are either synthetic or biological. And then the biological are TNF inhibitor, which we have talked about in the previous video, and the non-TNF inhibitor, which is the topic of today's video. Do you remember the TNF inhibitors? Yes, infliximab, adalimumab, etanercept. Once you confirm the diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis, you start the treatment immediately with DMARDs right now. And these are the 10 rules of treatment of rheumatoid. Treatment of rheumatoid consists of medical and surgical, medical non-steroidals, DMARD and others. DMARD, synthetic or biologic. Synthetic include methotrexate, sulfasalazine, leflunomide, hydroxychloroquine, tofacitinib, and there are other TNIBs that we'll talk about in the next video. And then the biologicals are either TNF or non-TNF. The TNF are infliximab, adalimumab, sertolizumab, golimumab, and etanercept, recept for receptor. Non-TNF inhibitors include abatacept, tocilizumab, rituximab, and anakinra. If it ends in mab, you know what? It's a monoclonal antibody. Tocilizumab is anti-interleukin-6. Anakinra is anti-interleukin-1. The other immunosuppressants include steroids, cyclosporin, cyclophosphamide, azathioprine, and mycophenolate mofetil. DMARDs are synthetic or biological. The biological are TNF or non-TNF. The TNFs are here. The non-TNFs are here. All of them can increase your risk of infections, including tuberculosis. What if my patient has an acute infection right now? Should I prescribe any biological DMARD? Shut up. Let's start with Mr. Abatacept. This is a non-TNF inhibitor DMARD. It's a selective T-cell co-stimulation inhibitor. We use it for rheumatoid arthritis. Imagine my shock, the side effects include infections and even COPD exacerbation, because one of the things that can exacerbate the COPD are freaking infections. Contraindications: if the patient has an infection right now, and before major surgery, because during major surgery, you are at a higher risk of infection. That's why we might prescribe antibiotics. The next one is Monsieur Tocilizumab. Tocilizumab is anti-interleukin-6 or interleukin-6 inhibitor, and here is my mnemonic. It's just right. Interleukin-6 mAb, monoclonal antibody against the interleukin-6. Uses for rheumatoid arthritis refractory to the TNF DMARDs. What are the TNF DMARDs? Infliximab, adalimumab, etanercept, and others. Side effects include infections, no kidding, myelosuppressions, which will lead to infections, and nephrotoxicity or hepatotoxicity, and then hyperlipidemia. Contraindications, same things. Anakinra. Medical students love this one because it's easy to remember. It's interleukin-1 inhibitor. You can write it down like this. But in real life, doctors don't love it that much. They believe that other DMARDs are more effective. Clinical uses, same thing, rheumatoid refractory to TNF DMARD. Anakinra requires daily injection. That's another reason why doctors don't like it. Side effects, infections, and the same contraindications. Rituximab, it ends in mab, so it's a monoclonal antibody. Against what? It has to be against something. So remember the mnemonic, 2x, so 2 times 10 equals 20. So it's a monoclonal antibody against CD20 B lymphocyte, because the CD20 is on the B lymphocyte. It's a cluster of differentiation. When you are anti-B lymphocyte, what are the clinical uses? B lymphocytes will become plasma cells and secrete autoantibodies, autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid. Those B lymphocytes, when they proliferate like crazy and they get mutations, they cause cancers, so lymphoma. And remember that they can secrete autoantibodies, which can lead to immune thrombocytopenia or ITP, so we can use them in ITP as well. What are the side effects of rituximab? TENTLSARDSPML. What is TEN? Toxic epidermal necrolysis. What is TLS? Tumor lysis syndrome. ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome or adult respiratory distress syndrome. PML is progressive because it's getting worse quickly. Multifocal because, you know, like, look at this, multifocal. Leukoencephalopathy. Leuko means white, so it's the white matter in your brain. It should be mater, not matter, because it means mother. That's why it's just one T and not double T. That's why the name of my channel is Medicosis Perfectionalis, because we get the lingo. How to decrease the risk of infections in a patient taking DMARDs. Screen for these before you prescribe the medication. Vaccines. You should give flu vaccine, pneumovaccine, etc. You should not give live attenuated vaccines, because these drugs will suppress the immunity, and live attenuated vaccines, if your immunity is weak, are not recommended, including patients who are taking DMARDs, patients who are taking any immunosuppressants, such as renal transplant patients, and then pregnant mothers. Pause the treatment during perioperative period before any major surgery. There is a new drug was approved in 2019 for rheumatoid arthritis. We'll talk about this in the next video. Obadacitinib. It ends in tinib. So what's gonna be the mechanism of action? Let me know the answer in the comment section. If you like my discussion on pharmacology, check out my antibiotics course on my website. You will love it. Also, you can check out my cardiac pharmacology course. Use promo code CardioPharm50 to get a 50% discount. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.